listen to a lot of Robert Randolph.
Yeah.
And who's a pedal steel player, but yeah, you know, similar kind of thing.
He plays it like it's like an electric. I mean, he's got distortion on it, so there you go.
Yeah,
I would have spotted that crossover. So
I don't really listen to that many blues guitarists.
Yeah.
I was brought up on metal and punk bands, so I listen to a lot of hard rock sort of stuff.
That's really interesting, isn't it? Yeah. You're here playing slide and you've come from hard rock, but you can hear that in your music. Definitely, yeah. That's really clear. I mean, listening to you guys play, and for you guys out there watching, Guthrie, two-piece, so you got drums and then yourself doing vocals and guitar, it's there's a lot of just raw energy there, isn't there? It's all about vibe.
Yeah, we just, you know, we wanted to sort of infuse the blues with the hard rock and sort of punk stuff that we listen to. And punk rock's about attitude, man. It's not about, it's not about the chords you're playing and how fast you're playing. It's so you can sort of put that into whatever style of music, really.
Yeah, cool.
It just happened to be the blues and on a slide.
Yeah, well, as soon as you go slide, it ends up having blues connotations anyway, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, that's a lot of rock comes back to blues roots.
Well, that's it. It's 100 years and it's still going strong. Hasn't gone fashion, man. So.
Cool.
Yeah.
So you've got a whole bunch of things I didn't realise till I got you in here today, that there's lots of things going on at the moment. You're doing a film clip tomorrow, and then you're embarking on a mammoth tour up the coast of Australia?
East Coast of Australia. We're doing East Coast tour. 50 plus dates at the moment. More to lock in, so we're quitting our jobs and leaving our pretty ladies and Lukey's beautiful son for 4 months and hitting the road.
Doing the dream.
Yeah. Just trying to live in a tent and sleep in the car and try not to kill each other.
I hope you've got a comfy pillow.
Yeah. Yeah.
What are your comforting things that you're taking with you to give you that sense of home? Obviously, you've got your instrument that keeps you grounded as well. But is there any sort of
lots of music, lots of good books?
Yeah,
we've got a portable DVD player, so we can sort of retire away from each other for a while, and you know.
The sanity, keeping sanity, 4 months. I'm just trying to imagine that.
A lot of driving.
Yeah. So you got a van?
We've got a Commodore wagon.
Yeah.
But we're a two-piece, so
that's the upside of less people.
We don't have to lug bass amps around, and
Yeah, awesome.
It makes it a bit easier.
Yeah. So up the east coast of Australia, you said the biggest tour you've done before is 4 weeks, so it's definitely a big step up. You're going to have a single coming out, which is the film clip, which we're going to have links for down underneath for you guys to check out, and also a performance of a song as well. We've got a link for with Liam doing performance here, and also a lesson as well. So all the links are available for you guys to check out there. So let's have a look at some techniques at getting this whole thing of slide going for people out there. They've bought themselves, either they've got their guitar and they've tipped it up, or tipped it down, whichever way you want to think of it. Obviously, high action is the first thing. The strings are really high, so that you're not fretting out and that sort of thing. And obviously, here we haven't even physically got frets. Yeah. You're just dealing. It's you're purely just floating, and then you got frets as guides. Actually, if you just want to hold that up for people to have a bit of a gander.
Yeah, basically, it's about half an inch, I suppose, clearance from the fretboard.
Yeah.
This doesn't have frets. It's got a acrylic fretboard with just markers on it.
Yeah.
So, you can do this on normal acoustic steel string guitar.
Yep.
If you like. The action needs to be a little bit higher.
Yeah.
But it's the blues, man. You know, you can get one of these, jam it under the strings at the bridge, raise it up a bit. I use quite heavy strings. These are like a 13 to 56. I don't use the top E, but so this is like a big old bit of fencing wire, basically. Mainly because it's down-tuned.
Yeah.
And you're putting a lot of tension on your strings when you belt this into the into the frets, like you're actually bending the strings down quite a bit. So you need a higher gauge string to sort of combat that, I suppose.
Yeah, yeah. All those technical things that you learn along. Yep. What's is has there been any ahas as you've been learning slide? A few things that, you know, just no one told you that you learnt yourself, or things that you wish you knew earlier.
Check out the Nail Guitar Skills channel to learn more guitar skills. And check out my other channels for heaps of free guitar training videos. If you're on Facebook or Twitter, you can catch me there also.